Be nice, girl. You have to pay a price, girl. They like to give advice, girl. Don't think about it twice, girl.
Time to get to work. Art isn't easy, even when you're hot. Advancing art is easy, financing it is not. Vision's just a vision if it's only in your head. If no one gets to hear it, it's as good as dead. It has to come to life.
Bit by bit, putting it together. Piece by piece, only way to make a work of art. Every moment makes a contribution, every little detail plays a part. Haven't had a vision, no solution. Everyone depends on execution. Putting it together, that's what counts.
By ounce, put it together. Small amounts adding up to make a work of art. First, you need a good foundation, otherwise it's risky from the start.
Takes a little cocktail conversation, but without the proper preparation.
Just a vision's no solution, everything depends on execution. The art of making art
is putting it together, bit by bit.
Link by link, making the connections.
Drink by drink, taking every comment as it comes.
Learning how to play the politician,
like you use piano, pace, and drums. Otherwise you'll find the composition isn't gonna get much exhibition.
Art isn't easy, every minor detail is a major decision. Have to keep things to scale, have to hold to your vision.
What's a little cocktail conversation if it gets the funds for your foundation? Every time I see, I feel defensive. I remember vinyl is expensive.
Dot by dot, building up the image. Shot by shot, keeping at a distance doesn't pay. Remember your objective.
Not give all your privacy away. A little bit of hype can be effective.
As long as you keep it in perspective, even when you get some recognition.
Everything you do is an audition.
Art isn't easy. Overnight you're a trend, you're the right combination. Then the trend's at an end, you're suddenly last year's sensation.
All they ever want is repetition. All they really like is what they know. Gotta keep a link with your tradition. Gotta learn to trust your intuition.
Want to reestablish your position so that you can be on exhibition. So that your work can be an exhibition.
Be new, girl. They tell you till they're blue, girl. You're new or else you're through, girl. And even if it's true, do what you can do.
Bit by bit, putting it together.
Piece by piece, working on the vision night and day.
While it takes time and perseverance, with a bit of luck along the way.
Gathering support is an adherence. Mapping out the songs, but in addition,
harmonizing each negotiation.
Balancing the parts with all the musicians. With the part that's strictly presentation.
Balancing the money with the mission, till you have the perfect orchestration.
You do have the suspicion that it's taken all your concentration.
The art of making art
is putting it together,
bit by bit,
beat by beat,
part by part,
sheet by sheet,
chart by chart,
track by track,
reel by reel,
snip by snack,
shout by shout,
spat by spat,
spiel by spiel. And that is the state of the art.
Sunday, everyone!
Happy Sunday indeed. We've got some gremlins apparently in my microphone.
In your microphone? No, in we just switched microphone. It off if we started.
Really? Oh, can I go back?
Try it.
Oh. Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah? So, welcome back. It's been over a month.
Too long!
I think it was Valentine's Day or somewhere near there that we were last live. But we are happy to be back with you all. Thank you so much. If you've never been to the show before, I'm Diana O'Brien.
I'm Becky O'Brien.
And together we are
the O'Brien sisters.
We do, as you have heard already, have Andrew over in the comment to...
In the comment corner
to receive all your comments, find out who's watching.
Oh, you talk. I'll talk. You just stand and try to look pretty.
Yes, we've got Andrew over in comment corner, so do leave some comments through the show so we can have a little chat with you. We love a little chat. If you've been here before, you know that.
And all you have to do, we're swap parts now, all you have to do for this free entertainment is share the show. So there should be a little button just beneath us being live, and it's an arrow, it says share, or go to your profiles for all your friends and family to see. Andrew?
So what is tonight's show called?
Tonight's show is called, I don't know the order, Bette, Babs and Barry.
And Neil.
No, Neil.
So we wanted some of our favourite artists, I'll bet. And some of our Barbara least. Streisand and Barry Manilow. And Andrew wanted Neil Diamond included too. Becky fought that.
I don't like Neil Diamond. I apologise to anyone who's a Neil Diamond fan. Just not my cup of tea.
Speaking
but
of
I might not be
tea.
His cup of tea either. So
if you want to go and get your cup of tea, I'm going to take the next one. So we're going to do a bit of a Bette number for you. This is From a Distance.
From a distance, the world looks blue and green, and the snow-capped mountains wide. From a distance, the ocean meets the stream, and the eagle takes to flight. From a distance, there is harmony, and it echoes through the land. And it's the voice of hope, it's the voice of peace, it's the voice of every man. From a distance, we all have enough, and no one is in need. And there are no guns, no bombs, and no disease, no hungry mouths to feed. From a distance, we of hope, playing songs of peace, they're the songs of every man. God is watching us, God is watching us, God is watching us from a distance. From a distance, you look like my friend, even though we are at war. From a distance, I just cannot comprehend what all this fighting is for. From a distance, there is harmony, and it echoes through the land. And it's the hope of hopes, it's the love of love, it is the heart of every man. It's the hope of hopes, it's the love of love. This is the song of every man. God is watching us.
God is watching us from a distance. God is watching us. God is watching. God is watching us from a distance.
Are you a choo-choo train?
Yes.
Whoop,
that would be choo-choo.
Oh, okay.
I was just applauding.
Oh, thank you.
Instead of coughing.
Yeah, I was about to say, normally you
cough. I thought something was wrong with my ears, actually. Now, Andrew, you need to keep us up to date. Do we need to come to you for comments now? Or
entirely up to you.
Becky, it's up to you then. I'll leave it to you. Do you want to do this?
Let's do a couple of comments.
All right.
Maybe just in case we lose them.
I'm going to clear up our music down here.
I'm just going to say, because I can see the screen, because my light is dimmer today, I look very tanned.
You always look very tanned
actually,
next
I look
to me.
More like a minion, but we'll go with it. Miss Simpson.
What?
A minion.
Oh, you said a minion.
I'm going to pick up the music.
Sorry. I sneezed a minute ago and...
You sneezed?
Yeah, I sneezed a minute ago and I've gone slightly deaf in the ear that you're speaking to. Handy, isn't it?
I was going to say, how convenient.
That and a wad of cotton wool. Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us. It's so lovely to be back with you and it's so lovely that you've joined us again. Mr. Miller, it says, so glad you're back, dears. Shared and ready to go. Hi to all the usual suspects. Jill May said, welcome back. Thank you, Jill. And Candace said, yay, Sunday in the park. And Candace also said, welcome back, everyone. She's missed everyone so much.
Oh, we've missed you too.
Steve May said, good evening all. And Jane is with us again. And she said, hello again, everyone. See what I did there? Because you haven't seen what I put across the bottom of the screen.
What have you put?
I put hello again, hello. Thank you for joining us.
No Neil Diamond
snuck in there. I'm not going to be told we're not having no Neil Diamond. And Alan is with us, kind of. He said, as usual, what Alan's put is as usual playing up. I think he means his computer and not him.
Although, can't be sure. Although it is Alan, so.
He's going to listen in later. Nice to have the Free Musketeers back. Well, thank you so much, Alan. Not me, because I've been sacked tonight. I was going to play one, but Becky has found...
Well,
something better.
I'm going to kind of interject here and say you were going to play one, but she did ask you to play another, and you didn't play that. So I think it was kind of a protest on
Becky's
part.
Well, you mentioned it about 4 days ago, and then.
Well, you need 4 days to read a piece of music.
No. Yeah, I've got to write. I have to write the letter names underneath and everything like that.
Colour code, keyboard.
Yeah, post-it notes on there. Roger Stevens says, "Great to be back. Greetings all. Appreciates you entertaining the usual suspects. Wonderful from Candace, who sent you some stars. Thank you so much, Candace. Joe said, "Oh, one of my favourites from the Divine Miss Midler. Mm-hmm. Beautiful Dinah dear." And Jane said, "See, you've done it now." You've messed it up for the rest of us, haven't you? Jane said, no Neil Diamond.
No.
Maybe a little.
Jane
little
said,
bit
I'm
later.
Going now.
Jane, come back.
Because, yeah, well, I'll sing you some Neil Diamond. Hello again. I might plug a piano in. Play.
Oh, yeah, my God.
And Jane said, weekend in New England. Absolutely. Because somebody had said, great opening. I think it was Joe. Great opening number of the years. I hope you sing my favourite song, Weekend in New England. Well,
I was going to sing Weekend in New England, but...
She's not.
I'm not. Because it was in the wrong key. And if I had a pianist who could change the keys, then we'd be all right. But he needs 4 weeks' notice, so...
But we also wanted to put in some...
You didn't mention anything. I came back last night.
Oh, dear. We've not been online so long. So sorry. This is...
If you've
never been before, this is what happens. We just quarrel and
bicker. You have to be explicit. You have to say, can you play this and can you take it down X amount?
And then you say no.
Do you believe that? I don't. Right. Okay, so lovely song, Dinah. That's from Candace. Lots of rounds of applause there. Joe said, it's okay, Becky, you look $1 million.
Oh, thank you.
Boom.
Candace said, good job, Becky, about 4 days to read the music. Good jab, Becky, about 4 days to read the music. Well, yeah. And then some. Jill Brandt said, nice to have you all back again. Sorry, Becky, I love a bit of Neil Diamond. She definitely,
who said that?
Jill Brandt.
Oh, no.
Probably most of the rest of your viewers, I would have thought, would want a little bit of
What's
Neil Diamond.
What's wrong with you all?
Although, actually, if honestly, we had too much Neil Diamond in this particular show, then it would ruin it for me, because I've been to all of the artists to see them in concert, but I haven't been to see Neil, so...
Has he given up?
That's not the theme of the show. It's not who I've seen in concert, but just happens to be.
In that case, it should have been Babs, Bette, Barry and Becky.
I wouldn't brag about seeing you in concert.
Oh, well, that's charming, isn't it?
I went to see Becky once. When did we go and see her? At the Dickensian place in Kent.
The Centennial.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And I was with your then manager.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And during the second act, he said, well, should we go for a pint?
I know, brilliant.
So we did.
See the support I have from the
I'm going to support
pianist.
You from the wings now.
Okay. Sing. Bear with me a second.
This is the one that Andrew was going to
but was sacked.
Yeah, because he can't play it. So, no. I'm joking. I just don't... I need some strings, and I didn't have a string quartet to hand, so... this one...
I would have got one.
Would you? I'll ask next time. So this one, I'm going to do a little dedication for this one. A few years back when I was living in New York, I did my show in a lovely theatre called the Laurie Beachman on 42nd Street. And a guy came along to watch my show with a mutual friend. And we made friends, and he was a TV producer and was super interested in helping me produce my next show. And he actually was like, I love you. You remind me of Bette Midler because you're really sassy and little and you've got big boobs. I mean, not a bad review. But unfortunately, he passed away a few months ago. So I thought I would do this one for him. So this is for Andrew.
You've got to give a little, take a little, and let your poor heart break a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love. Got to laugh a little, cry a little, until the clouds roll by a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love. As long as there's the two of us, we've got the world and all its charms. And when the world is through with us, we've got each other's arms. You've got to win a little, lose a little, yes, and always have the blues a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love. Love.
Almost perfect.
Thanks.
Obviously. Just the backing track.
That's with a nice praise.
It was a nice praise. Yeah, thank you.
We're going to stick with a bit of Bette, but we're going to add in some Barry.
Oh. Barry's making a slight entrance.
Just for any of our usual suspects, not Barry Tanner, just to clarify, it's Barry Manilow that we are singing tonight. Yes.
I didn't know that.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, just so I thought there might be some confusion, actually. Oh. Yeah, so.
Well, I have fully prepared the wrong show. I'm so sorry.
Bette and Barry. Oh, he's not done it.
Hey, Dinah.
Hey, Becky.
Should we sing a little duet?
No.
What do you mean, no?
I don't want to.
I was thinking Bette and Barry.
Barry Manilow?
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna get you on a slow boat to China, all to myself alone. Get you and keep you in my arms evermore. Waiting on a faraway shore, out on the briny where the moon's big and shiny, melting your heart of stone. I'm gonna get you on a slow boat to China, all to myself alone.
I do like this one.
Do you?
Yeah.
If only we had a piano player in the house that could play it.
I know.
Such a
shame. Then we could have a key change.
That would be nice.
Should we take it up anyway?
I'm gonna get you.
You're never gonna get me.
Boat to China.
Not in a fast or slow boat at any
myself.
I just get motion sick.
I'm gonna make you mine.
You'll have to stand in line.
Get you and keep you in my band evermore.
Now there's a new attack.
Leave all the others on the shore.
For me, they swim to China and back.
Out on the briny,
I wouldn't like the oceans
big and shiny.
Not even in a rowboat.
Melting your heart of stone. Come on, what do you say?
You always get your way.
I'm gonna get you on a slow boat to China, all to myself.
That one.
That's a nice one. I think we should keep that one.
I think we should keep that one.
What do you see?
What do you say?
What do you say?
What do you see?
What do you say? What do you think? What do you feel?
Andrew, we're coming to you anyway. Are you all right?
What have you got your hand up for?
To tell you I wanted to ask a question.
But in the middle of a song?
Yeah, in the middle of... No, we're not in the middle of...
Did you hear him
shouting? I know. I was like...
Yeah, the bit where you said, I always get my own way.
I didn't say that.
I said she always gets her own way.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Did you? Now, I'm
not
curious.
Always.
I'm going to come to your wonderful comments in a minute, but I'm curious about, was the digging at the pianist?
Yeah, that was...
Was that written
was
into the song? Or
yeah,
was it?
Yeah.
I'm not sure I believe them.
It was.
Well,
I have to go and listen to the original.
Right, okay. So back to the future and back to your comments. Joe Miller said, can you do Ready to Take a Chance again, dears?
It's in the wrong key. It's in the wrong key is the problem.
You're playing in the wrong key.
We'll come back to some Barry in a future show.
We need to do a lot more Barry.
Because we do love Barry Manilow, but because he's got a very big range and he's a man.
we've got a very big range,
but we're female. So it's trying to find the right key for us.
Got to get it right on the button.
So the answer to that question is no.
All of your fans have tuned in and you're supposed to...
We're not giving them any songs.
No.
We're giving the other ones.
Right, moving on. So Candace said, oh, family love. I so look forward to this banter. And Candace also said, so beautifully done, Becky. And that was a...
Thank you.
A lovely arrangement. Candace. And you got some stars from Candace. Thank you so much. Gorgeous Becky from Jane. Round of applause from Candace. What a beautiful tribute, Becky. That's from Mr. Miller, who also said, please tell me you're doing Otto Titzling. I know you've sung it many times before, but you do it so well, and it's one of Joe's favourites.
But we're going to have another...
You're not going to say no.
We've got a late night show.
Yeah, we weren't going to put it in, but we could... We might be able to.
What, without rehearsing it?
Yeah, we did it before. We've never rehearsed that one.
Well, I thought you were going to put it in a late night show again because you were going to. What's the other one you're going to do?
I'm going to do Long Legs and Great Big Knockers.
Oh. That's what we should be called as an act. Long Legs and Great Big Knockers.
Oh, yeah, because I've got such long legs.
You have compared to me.
That's true. And you've got. Anyway, Andrew.
That was great, Becky, from Jean Cunnington. Martin said, so lovely to have you back on a Sunday evening. Thank you, Martin. And it's so lovely that Martin is back with us. Jane said, though you were going to do the Ballad of Frieda and Barry, thought you were going to do the Ballad of Frieda and Barry from it. We did that before, didn't we?
We did do it, yeah.
In one of the late night shows.
I think it was the first late night show.
Maybe we should revisit that.
Yeah. Great to hear you both singing again from Jean. Lots of round of applause. And
notice she didn't say she was missing you playing. Just saying. Mm-hmm. Carry on.
And Joe said, yes, please put it in.
Oh.
We'll see how we're going.
Very polite of you, Joe.
So, this next song, brand new for me, but I do love it. It's not the arrangement that I wanted, and that's nothing to do with Andrew.
Honestly, come on.
I realised as I said it.
She doesn't even get preference, so she's married to you.
That's nothing to do with Andrew. It's just this is the only arrangement that is out there.
If only you knew someone who could have done an arrangement.
If only you knew someone who hadn't been away this weekend.
Oh, the excuses.
He's been very busy.
Hold on, if you have been away, then you would not have been able to do the arrangements that I wanted either, would you? So you just like making a drama?
No, there's a difference between doing an arrangement of something, like with all the instruments and stuff, to sitting down and playing it at the piano.
I wanted instruments.
Well, that takes quite a long time to do.
Exactly my point. So you couldn't have done it anyway.
Well, perhaps get organised.
Goodbye. Don't try to stop me now, Horace. Please. Wave your little hand and whisper so long, dearie. You ain't gonna see me anymore. But when you discover that your life is dreary, don't you come a knocking at my door. For I'll be all dolled up and singing that song that says, you dog, I told you so. So wave your little hand and whisper so long, dearie, dearie, should have said so long ago. Because you treated me so rough and rough, I'd had enough of feeling low. So wave your little hand and whisper so long, dearie, dearie, should have said so long ago. For I can hear that choo-choo calling me up to a fancy new address. Yes, I can hear that choo-choo calling me up on board that happiness express. I'm gonna learn to dance and drink and smoke a cigarette. I'm gone as far away from Yonkers as a girl can get. So and on those cold winter nights, Horace. You can snuggle up to your cash register. It's a little lumpy, but it rings. Don't come a-knockin' a cold, old up and singin' that song that says, you dog, I told you so. So hurry,
this you will find yourself a sad old sorry. When you see your dolly shuffle up to glory, should have sat so long, so long ago.
Very nice. I like that one.
I love that one. But I do like the... I almost did it, actually. I almost went into the key change of the Streisand arrangement because that is
the one that
Barbara Streisand and a Bette Midler.
So I'm learning. I'm guessing that's from Hello, Dolly.
Which they both played the part of.
And
so Streisand was in the film and Bette played Dolly on Broadway a couple years ago.
And the first time I saw it was Christmas this year, actually. Yeah. Christmas just gone.
It had taken me that long to get him to watch it. And he loved it, though.
Yeah, very good.
It's one of my favourite musicals, Hello, Dolly. Yeah.
And then the story was, so Streisand obviously did Hello, Dolly, the movie, and then Bette did Hello, Dolly on Broadway. And they were supposed to, around about the same time, Bette had done Gypsy, the movie, and Streisand was supposed to go on to do a Gypsy on either a tour or Broadway, but it never happened.
Oh.
Oh, well.
Sabotaging yourself, dear.
Little frog in the throat.
So, we've moved from Bette to some Babs. Mm-hmm. You're going to stick with some Babs?
There. I am going to stick with some Babs from Funny Lady.
I loved the man, truly I did. When he would touch me, I'd act like a love-hungry kid. Isn't this better? Somebody nice, somebody new, someone who lets me react as I usually do. Isn't this better? Better? Passion is fine, but passion burns fast. Passion's design seems never to last. Better a match, better a blend. Who needs a lover? I need a friend. Now I am calm, safe and serene. Heartache and hurt are no longer a part of the scene. Isn't this better the way it should be? Better for him and also much better. Isn't this better, better? Passion is fine, but passion burns fast. Passion's design seems never to last. Better a match, better a blend. Who needs a lover? I need a friend. Now I am calm, safe and serene. Heartache and hurt are no longer a part of the scene. Isn't this better the way it should be? For me.
song.
I think one of my favourite Barbara songs.
Yeah.
And I think the music in Funny Lady is so underrated.
It is.
I love the music from Funny Girl.
So do I, but I actually prefer Funny Lady.
I think so too.
Still not seen it, but love that song.
Yeah.
So the story behind that song, obviously Funny Lady is like Funny Girl based on the life of Fanny Brice. So Fanny Brice was married initially to Nicky Onstein, who she was madly in love with and lustful for and everything. And when she split up from Nick, she met Billy Rose.
William Rose, who was a composer and songwriter.
And she thought he was kind of cute and kind of funny and kind of, you know, a bit Jack the Lad, and was a bit of a match for her, really.
As our songwriters tend to be, cute, funny.
But she said, Fanny said that she fell in love with Nick, but she fell in like with Billy. But Billy always felt that he was in Nick's shadow, and that's where the song Me and My Shadow comes from.
Yeah. Whereas Dinah fell in tolerance with me, didn't you?
Yeah, not so much.
Yeah, I've not written a song about that yet.
So it's still like it would have a marching sound.
Yeah, okay, I'll work on it.
Like dum 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 dum, like that, yeah.
If anyone has any lyrics you want to send them across to me, I'll see what I can do. So we're going to stick with some Babs. But we're going to add in, Jane, I hope you're still out there. I hope you stayed, because we're going to add in...
Neil.
Oh, no. It's a bit of Neil coming now.
Going to have a bit of Neil.
You don't bring me flowers. You don't sing me love songs.
You hardly talk to me anymore when I come through the door at the end of the day.
I remember when you couldn't wait to love me. Anymore, they just lay on the floor till we sweep them away.
Baby, I remember all the things you taught me.
I learned how to laugh and I learned how to cry.
Well, I learned how to love and I learned how to lie.
So you think I could learn so how to tell you goodbye,
how to tell you goodbye.
You don't bring me flowers anymore. You don't say you need me.
It's a long ending.
Do you know, Dinah? Dinah, you see that light on the floor?
This one?
The one on the floor. Can you turn it around? Because it's
toward making, this way.
Yeah, anywhere, because it's making your head look a bit
big.
It's you.
Long ending and a big head.
Yes. That's fine. Now, do you know, that's the. You've done that Neil Diamond song. It's the only one of the only Neil Diamond songs I can't stand.
See, I actually really liked that song.
You don't like that song either, do you? I don't mind the song.
And fun fact, although maybe not fun, I don't know. It's a fact anyway, I'm going to tell you.
Boring fact.
Useless information. They didn't plan on doing that duet. It was a DJ, who decided to put Barbara Streisand's recording and Neil Diamond's recording together and see what it sounded like. And then they heard it and they were like, oh, maybe we should do it, because it was really popular.
So why didn't you want to do a duet with Neil before?
They grew up together, so don't go there. They did the whole
thing. We grew up together, but I don't mean anything.
Yeah, I don't want to sing with you either.
Yeah, doesn't want a duet with you.
I can't remember when we were last at comments, but shall I sing?
I don't know.
Do we need comments?
Let's go to comments.
Yeah, let's have some comments.
Why not?
He loves to talk.
I do.
We can't shut him up.
I just don't want to lose. Honestly.
He's feeling all left out because he didn't get to play piano.
Yes. Right. So, Sell It to Dinah from Dolly. That's from Candace.
Thank you.
And Fantastic Dinah. That's from Jean. A round of applause for Candace. Fabulous Dinah from Jane. Wonderful song, Becky. One of my favourites from the movie. Very, very rich.
Oh, thank you. Who's that?
Candace.
Yeah, I was going to say, no one else has seen it, have you?
No, lots of rounds of applause. Wonderful, Becky. Love this one. That's from Jean. Round of applause from Joe, from Candace. Lovely, Becky, from Jill, who also sent you some stars. Thank you so much, Jill. And Candace said, well, Simon would have bawled if you had done that on BGT. I'm crying now.
Oh. But he probably wouldn't know what it is.
Yeah.
They like a very...
Although one of Simon Cowell's favourite songs is...
With You.
From Ghost.
That, but more to do with this show.
The Ying Tong song.
The Way We Were.
Oh.
Oh, is it?
Mm? Not the Ying Tong song.
Ying Tong song.
They did want me originally to do...
To do the Ying Tong song.
No, to do the Streisand version of Tomorrow for my semi-final.
Oh, I don't like that.
Well, I just thought it was a bit... Yeah.
Yeah.
It's nice to listen to. Ching, 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 ching.
There's a really nice version of Tomorrow that was arranged by a guy called Andrew Earwaker.
Was it?
And the artist, actually, Dinah O'Brien. It's available. I think... I don't know if it's a purchase or if it was a free. I can't remember.
I don't know if we put that one out on iTunes, to be honest.
Well, if not,
I think it's up there somewhere.
So, just
out of curiosity, there's another really nice arrangement of a Bette Midler song, which, had the instruments, had all that stuff. It was done as a rush job for you overnight once.
What song?
And I just noticed looking at the playlist...
Because we've done it before.
You've done all of these before.
No, we haven't.
Look at it. We've never done Putting It Together.
We've never done So Long, Dear.
We've never done Slow Boat to China.
We've never done Flowers.
You've done From Distance, done Glory of Love.
Right.
You've done Isn't It Better?
Right, but that's
done,
three. That's it.
Hang on.
No, well, you can't say anymore because we're not there yet. You'll give the game away.
Yeah. So, hold on,
there's definitely my next one I haven't done before.
Wait, what's your next one? Where are we?
She hasn't.
See?
Okay.
Back to comments.
The point remains. Anyway, right, so Joe said, totally agree, Dinah. Funny lady, so much better. And Andrew, sorry, what? You haven't seen it? Dinah, sort him out. Well, she's been trying for a long time, Joe, and has made no inroads there.
But he's seen Hello, Dolly now. So.
Jane, yeah, I've seen Hello. I mean, that's a start, isn't it? Jane said, not seen the film, but on the basis of that song, I'm definitely going to have to watch it.
Yeah,
it's good.
So Jane and I haven't seen it, so we'll have an evening round at Becky's.
Good.
If it involves watching Funny Lady, then yes.
You can serve the drinks that night, and that would be wonderful. Thank you very much. And Candace said, I agree with Dinah and Joe also. Jane said she loves a bit of Neil, and who doesn't?
Thank goodness she stayed.
I don't.
I do.
His voice when he sings. He sounds like
he's not the R-Wise man.
It sounds like to me. Hello again. Hello.
I think you might be listening shivering to a really bad impressionist, because he doesn't sound
like... He does to me. Or you just... don't bring me flowers. It's like he's shivering.
Are you listening to him on vinyl that's strapped to a horse?
Yeah.
No.
I like Neil Diamond. So you're in good company.
And his hair annoys me.
Oh,
it does. It's fluffy like candy floss.
Diana, I've got a theory about this, and you know what my theory
yes.
is.
I think it's absolutely right.
And I told you, I'm not wrong on this.
What? Reminds me of your music. No, it's not. It's Mr. Claydon did not sing like that. He was like, bob, dilly, bob, bob.
No,
he definitely
really
looked
not,
a bit like.
But there was a
fluffy
look,
hair.
There was a look, wasn't there? Right. Jane also said she loves a bit of Neil, just don't tell Char, just don't tell her partner. And this is wonderful, your voices blend so beautifully.
Thank you.
Oh, thanks.
And lots of rounds of applause from other people there as well. While we're on, it's getting towards that time, isn't it?
What time?
That we're not going to have many shows
This living room.
In this living room. So I think we need to soon we'll be putting out when the final one from here will be. And it will probably be towards, the end of May, but I don't really think we're going to get many chances to go live before that one. So keep an eye out, everybody.
Yeah.
We've got to try and fit in another late night show before that.
Yeah,
as well.
We've definitely got to do the late night show before we head off.
Yeah. But don't worry, even though it will be the last one in this living room, we are going to endeavour to carry on doing the shows as often as we are able to do so with the distance between us. So we're not going anywhere.
Which means Dinah will phone me and go, get your ass up the motorway.
Yes, pretty much, yeah.
Hang on a second. What, and you'll get in the car and race up the motorway?
No.
No.
In a few weeks.
With notice. I'm a very busy girl, you know.
I'm going to take this...
I wasn't what I was referring to.
I'm going to take this next song, and I have done this one before, Andrew, but I've only done it once in the...
Why didn't you do The Rose?
Because we did that as a duet. I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm very, very sorry I've let everyone down by doing a repeated song.
I have no problem.
But I hope you like it.
Excuse me. I have no problem with repeated songs.
As long as they're the ones that you've arranged.
They're the ones that I spent a lot of time doing, then yeah, fine.
Okay, well, this is one of my favourites. It's not necessarily an obvious Streisand song, but it's a beautiful one.
Pretty.
What are you doing the rest of your life? North and south and east and west of your life. I have only one request of your life, that you spend it all with me. All the seasons and the times of your days, all the nickels and the dimes of your days, let the reasons and the rhymes of your day all begin and end with me. I want to see your face in every kind of light, in fields of dawn and forests of the night. And when you stand before the candles on the cave, let me be the one to hear the silent wish you make. Those tomorrows waiting deep in your eyes, in a world of love you keep in your eyes, I'll awaken what's asleep in your eyes. It may take a kiss or two. Yeah. is all of my life.
The only cough tonight.
It is. Yeah, it was only a little one.
It was a little one.
Not in my room, wasn't it?
What are you reading over there? Huh? What are you reading?
No, you're making it sound like I'm reading a book or something. I'm not. I'm just looking at the set list.
Oh, okay.
So, I just need to know, before you do your solo, are we adding in Otto Titzling this evening?
Oh, not without rehearsing it. I can't remember.
Okay, so Joe, you're just going to have to make sure you're there at the next late night show and we will get the date.
It's very wordy. Wordy.
You lost your bottle.
I don't remember who sings what part as well. I know most of it because I always put it on when I'm in the dressing room getting ready for a show. That's my warm-up song.
That's, yes.
What?
I do that for church.
But I don't remember how we sang it.
We never planned it.
Oh. Late night show.
Late night show. We'll do it. Definitely.
Bit of Barry.
Even now, when there's someone else who cares, when there's someone home who's waiting just for me, even I think about you as I'm climbing up the stairs, and I wonder what to do so he won't see that even now, when I know it wasn't right and I found a better life than what we had, even now I wake up crying in the middle of the night, and I can't believe it still could hurt so bad. Even never hear your name, and the world has changed so much since you've been gone. Even now I still remember, and the feeling's still the same, and the pain inside of me goes on and on. I
very abrupt ending.
We never got to the ending of some of these drags, that's why.
That's the rehearsal that's process we got. Right?
I love that song. Yeah, it's lovely.
Oh, nice. I would have loved to. I'd love to have heard how it ended.
That was how it ends, but it's
a surprise.
A very, very quick fade. Quick fade to end.
Well, see, you need the full orchestra to do lots of encores. Oh, and, yeah. What can you do?
So we have arrived at
the penultimate song.
I'm glad we rehearsed that bit.
That's the only bit we ever rehearsed. But we will be back soon, not next week. We
can't give you a very precise date,
but we will be back soon, as soon as we can.
So we're going to do this one, last comments?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, bit of a... do you know what? Can you get rid of him?
But do you know what? I don't think we've done this one for about 2 years.
I agree. I agree.
So some of these people may not have even
far,
seen it.
Far, far longer back than far, we did. Far, far, longer. Far away. Compared to when we did the rose, dear.
Oh, about the same.
Okay. No, it wasn't. I guarantee. Anyway, Barbara Duet.
Shh.
Raining pouring.
not agree more. Enough is enough.
I almost couldn't sing it because I was laughing.
And why was that?
Because she was making me laugh. Uh-huh.
And why was that, Steiner?
Because she was pointing at you.
Yeah, I know.
She'd been cheeky. Final comments for today.
Yeah, never a dull moment in here, is it? Right.
Not when I'm here.
Never a quiet moment. Nope. Okay, right, back to you for the last time this evening, and then we can all go and Becky will cook for us. Isn't that great? Right.
Have you been shopping then?
No. No, it's a bit like old Mother Hubbard's cupboard out there. Right, okay. Where did we get to?
Well, you would know if you weren't sitting playing on your phone.
I was researching.
No, you weren't. You were playing snooker.
Yeah, I was playing snooker. It was pool, actually. Anyway.
Oh, that's all right, then.
Okay, so, right. Stunning Diner, that's from Joe. That was 12 minutes ago. Wonderful Diner from Steve May.
Thank you.
What was it you sing?
What are you doing the rest of your life?
That's a very nice song. What's that from?
Did you not listen to it?
Do you know what? I don't know what it's from. But it's written by the Bergmans. And
You've just come around to stir up trouble, haven't you?
She stirred up a hornet's nest.
She stirred up a hornet's nest. Stirred up a bloody hornet's nest.
Written by the Bergmans, so I don't know.
Okay. Who are they? Are they your neighbours?
Who are they?
The Bergmans from up the road.
They used to collaborate a lot with Marvin Hamlisch.
Oh.
You would know a lot of their music.
I would.
But I can't think of any others right now.
Okay.
It's not helpful.
It's not. Right, beautiful Diana. I love the slight looks at Andrew. Well, I'm glad someone did, Candace.
That was for what are you doing the rest of your life?
Yes. Oh.
Not for enough is enough. Although she might have liked that too.
I wasn't paying attention there. Sorry. And beautiful, that's from Ricky Murphy. Jane Collins sent you some stars. Thank you, Jane. Candace said, Becky, I love this song. Thanks for performing this so well.
Thanks.
What was that for?
Even now.
Oh, that's no wonder you're checking the set list. You're not listening to a thing you're doing.
I listen to it. I just have not very good at retaining.
Like Dory.
Like Dory, yeah. I'm not very good. I can't remember my name half the time. And Jane said, takes me right back to the days when she was a geeky teen. I don't believe you were ever a geeky teen, Jane. And Joe said, that was amazing. And Joe said, another fantastic show, dears. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
The penultimate song is by far the most enchanting song of the show.
Is that Candace?
That is Candace, yes. I think we should commit that to a recording.
Yes. We've got so many to commit to a recording.
We never got round to doing
the album. We need to try and perhaps do that.
Mm-hmm. Or the theme song for Live in the Living Room.
Or the theme song for the Live in the Living Room.
Yeah, but the thing is, we could do an album with just my arrangements, you see, already.
We could.
Yeah.
We could if you'd get round to doing them.
But you never sing my arrangements. You don't like them.
She's done a few duets.
Yeah.
What do you mean I never sing your arrangements?
You always like the big band.
I don't like the big band. I just like the right notes in the right places.
We will try.
Don't we all?
Don't
we all?
Don't take this as gospel or any sort of promise, but we will try to perhaps get the album done for after we've moved.
Well, that's any time ever.
Yeah, that is.
I mean, like once you finish studying.
Great. Let me put that date in my diary.
What are you doing the rest of your life?
You just get. The way to keep them there is to keep them holding on to the hope that they're getting an album.
One day.
Yeah, one day.
It'll be before I die.
I was thinking about this the other night, actually. I was thinking we should...
We've got 53 volumes to do.
Yeah. It'd be bigger than
this. And we need the theme song committed.
Live in the living room. Da, 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 da. And I've got way more lyrics to add now because we've done so many more shows.
Praise the Lord. I, for one, can only just give thanks for this. So really, yes. All right, then. We'll think about theme songs, see if we get that down for the last show. And Jill said, a brilliant evening. Thank you, Andrew. You'll be getting the sack soon. Thank you, Jill. I think I already have. And Roger said, many thanks. Great show. Look forward to the next one.
Oh, thank you.
We're going to slot one in, aren't we?
As soon as we've got as
romance is not dead in this house.
As soon as we've got the space.
We can't do one for the next 2 weeks, don't you think? Because no. Becky's not here next week. And then
you're not here.
Yeah, we're...
Well, we're not here the week after.
We're not here the week after, yeah.
So perhaps the beginning of April.
Oh.
Mm. So hopefully not too long.
I'm away then.
Not then.
Oh, we'll have to do it without him.
April 2025. Oh,
good luck.
Oh, yeah.
That's not going to happen. I'm not bigging myself up here, but that just is not going to happen. Yeah. Right. Jane said, this is fabulous. Sorry?
Nothing?
Mm-hmm. Will you two stop? Jane said, this is fabulous. I'm assuming that was for...
Enough is enough.
Could not agree more.
Brackets, no more tears.
Because it was on an album about water?
Yes. So it was actually called No More Tears. And then the parenthesis was no enough is enough.
Yeah.
Because the album was wet.
Because they wanted to shoehorn that song in, so yeah. They had to put the No More Tears bit at the front, didn't they?
Shoehorn it in.
And we'll just carry on. We'll just let them chat amongst themselves.
Carry on.
Joe said, Robert and he are having a boogie. Terrific show, you three.
Is that what we're calling it now?
That's from Cancer. I'm just going to press on. Jean said, thank you, Dinah, Becky and Andrew, for another wonderful evening's entertainment.
Dinah and Becky is what she means.
One day, I'm going to show you. Next time we do this, I might do a little behind-the-scenes documentary for you.
Keep on talking, because I've got a recording of Becky rehearsing it even now last night.
What you done?
Nothing. It was we just recorded it for you.
She's going to be. Dinah, what are you putting on?
Candace said, "Does the UK get to see the Oscars this evening, or is that at a later date? Do we get to see it tonight, just get the highlights? I think we just get highlights.
I've not been able to find out when we can watch.
Oh, I know what you're going to do. Don't do that.
Probably watch it online." Candace said, "Rest of Your Life was the play out music for the movie The Happy Ending."
Ah, thank you.
That sounds fun. That's a movie.
I am so sorry. The happy ending lost the Oscar to Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head.
It's a great song.
Right.
Another wet
one. Oh yeah, this is Becky's rehearsal. I'm going to say goodbye.
It's not my rehearsal.
It was. This is Becky last night.
No, it's not.
That was horrific.
Coming from you last night rehearsing.
I kept singing everything down the octave.
She was like, and I was like, why don't you sing up the octave? Oh, yeah, that's better.
So, right. Andrew, have you said adieu?
I kind of did. Thank you all for joining us. I will see you when we see you.
And I'm going to ask you for a little fade in on this track.
All right. Tell me when to fade in.
I will. Thank you so, so much to all of you who have liked, shared, commented, sent style, sent tips.
Watched.
And for being there. Yeah, that's the most important thing.
You can. Oh, he's got to get back on the other camera, isn't he? What's he going up? Where are you going?
I'm not on the camera. I'm
You do the send-off.
The send-off?
Happy ending.
I feel like it's like a funeral. Why am I doing
that? Oh, no. Cheerio.
I'll do the happy ending. Yes. Yes. So, it was lovely to see you all. We'll be back very soon. Hopefully with a late night show. Because I do like a late night show.
Oh, yes.
Bit of Barry to finish off with. Not finishing off a bit of Barry, by the way.
Yeah, that would be happy in the right.
Be dancing along. Oh, also, well done to our nephew, Teddy, who won his ballroom competition today.
Yay!
First and 2 seconds. Didn't dance like this though.
No. That's not running family.
Her name was Lola. She was a showgirl with yellow feathers in her hair and her dress cut down to there.
She would merengue and do the cha cha. And while she tried to be a star, Tony always tended by.
Across the crowded floor,
they worked from 8 till 4.
They were young and they had each other.
Who could ask for more?
At the Copacabana, the hottest spot north of Havana. Here at the Copacabana, music and passion are always the fashion at the Copa.
His name was Rico. He wore a diamond. He was escorted to his chair. He saw Lola dancing there.
And when she finished, he called her over. But Rico went a bit too far. Tony sailed across the bar.
And then the punches flew.
And chairs were smashed in two.
There was blood in a single gunshot.
But just who shot who? Abdelkofa, Copacabana, the hottest spot north of Havana. Here at the Copa, Copacabana, music and passion were always the fashion at the Copa.
She lost her
to have a show.
Now it's a disco, but not for Lola. Still in the dress she used to wear, faded feathers in her hair.
She sits there so refined
and drinks herself half blind.
She lost her youth
and she lost her Tony. Now she's lost her mind.
At the Copa, Copacabana, the hottest spot north of Havana. Here at the Copa, Copacabana,
have a fade out, and we will see you very, very soon.